Ajax stands for Asynchronous JavaScript and XML Request. We could ignore the XML part of the acronym. For now, let's just think of it as an asynchronous JavaScript request. Ajax requests allow for content retrieval and display without reloading the web page. Asynchronous in Ajax refers to the fact that the request doesn't block other events from happening. Instead, the page keeps on doing its thing and then only acts on the data when it gets returned by the server. Ajax requests occur in a number of different ways and with varying levels of difficulty. Some require an API key, others use OAuth, and some don't use any authentication at all. And the data returned by different Ajax requests differs too. X in Ajax stands for XML, which used to be the dominant hierarchical data format. But today, JSON is much more popular. In fact, most Ajax requests nowadays are actually a JAJ request, standing for Asynchronous JavaScript and JSON requests, but it doesn't sound as nice, so we still just call them Ajax. Embedded within Ajax responses, it's pretty common to see HTML, which websites can use to fill in part of the page. As part of the project for this course, you'll have to try three different asynchronous request techniques. You'll have to work with the Google Street View, Wikipedia, and New York Times APIs, all three of which work very differently.